Hello everybody, this is Neeta. I am delighted to be here. I hope that all of you having a wonderful start with week so far. In my previous session, we had discussed about mass media, its advantage and disadvantage, and in some extent the concept and importance of print media. And today I am here to talk about the types of print media. In particular, we will deep dive into the newsletter and its elements in detail. Before jumping directly into the types of print media, let's recall what is print media. When message reaches to a large number of people within a printed form or in written form is called print media. Print media include such form as newspaper, magazines, books, newsletters, advertising, memos, business form, and many more others. These are instructional tools and support material with text and illustrations available in printed form. Print media is the oldest media in education. This category of media is useful for not only educational and informational purpose, but motivational purpose too. We use them to convey verbal information through print. After learning the definition of the print media, let's distinguish the different types of print media. Particularly, I am going to discuss six types of media. Out of them, one most popular form of print media is a newspaper. A newspaper is a periodical publication containing written information about current events, articles of opinion, features, and advertising. Newspapers collect, edit, and print news reports and articles. The second type is a magazine. A magazine is a periodical publication containing a variety of articles that is related to more specific target group. Magazines are generally published on a regular schedule and contain a variety of content. The third form of print media is a book. A book is a collection of paper, parchment, or other material with a piece of text written on them, bound together along one edge, usually within covers. Each side of a sheet is called a page, and a single sheet within a book may be called a leaf. A book is also a literary work or a main division of such work. The next type of print media is brochure. Brochures gives detailed information about the product. These are mainly distributed at events or even at the main outlet when a consumer needs to read in detail about the product. Then the booklet is also a popular form of print media. Booklet is a small book with only a few pages that contain information on a particular subject. And the sixth type of the print media, which I am going to discuss in the detail, is a newsletter. Newsletter is a shortened form of newspaper and informational letter. These target the specific group of audience and give specific information on the product. Newsletters are about keeping your audience up to date with the latest development in your company, school, or club. For example, newsletter distributed at university to inform students and employees about the events activities happen there. They are sent on a predictable schedule to inform readers of sales, promotion, new features, reunions, and events. Okay, let me now move on to the second next topic, which is the basic elements of newsletter designing. Before designing it, some points should be keep in your mind while you're writing for the newsletter. Before you begin, you need to find out who is the audience, who is the publication distributed or aimed at, what is the expected word count of the article, are photos and illustration needed, and what is the style of newsletter. For the style of the newsletter, you can see the some past editions of the newsletter and a thorough discussion with the editor, and then select whether it is a chatty, academic, serious or light-hearted. Once you have got some answers to the above question, you will have a good idea of what style of articles to write. Don't just think that there is a one way to write a newsletter article. In fact, there are many different styles. Few are like personal story or personal reflection. In this, you write an article on the basis of your experiences and past observation. For examples, year ago, I was treating an asthmatic patient with a severe illness and I discovered. The next style is the chatty and the casual style, where the writing of the article is in the conversation style. Like, our meeting program was excellent and I am happy to see my all delegates. Well done to the organizing committee. The third style is the formal business writing style, where you write the article in formal way. For example, the program aims to increase access to CPD by rural health professionals, in particular rural nurses. And the fourth style is the academic and research style, where you write your article on the basis of the empirical study and the result. Like, the result found over 50% of participants had considered medicinal cannabis use. Last but not the least is the letter to the editor, or it is an opinion piece, where you just express your opinion in form of an article and send to the editor. For example, dear editor, I was concerned with the articles in the November issue regarding this. So eventually, whatever writing style you are going to adopt for the newsletter article, mind your audience. Your audience is the first and foremost criteria for selecting the design of your newsletter article. Point should be keep in your mind that newsletter must be people to people, not institution to institution. So I hope that you got a good understanding of the style of a newsletter article. Well, that lead me to the next topic, that is a parts of a basic newsletter. As you can see, that slide illustrates you the basic parts of a newsletter, and these are the folio, nameplate, headline, subheadline, byline, graphics, logo, subtitle, body. Well, next question comes in your mind, that what is this and how I can use in my newsletter. So I am going to explain these basic components of the newsletter with the help of the example. And for this, I actually analyze the one newsletter which being implemented by SDAU University. Well, almost all essential components of the newsletter is incorporated in this newsletter. So I hope that it gives you a clear idea about the proper use of the elements of the newsletter. Let's discuss one by one. The first foremost part of the newsletter is the nameplate. The banner on the front of a newsletter that identifies the publication is its nameplate. The nameplate usually contains the name of the newsletter, possibly graphics or a logo, and perhaps a subtitle, motto, and public information including volume and issue or date. As you can see, this is the nameplate of the newsletter. The name of the newsletter is the SDAU newsletter, is mentioned here. Here is the logo of the university. Here is the volume and the month of the publication. Well, the nameplate must be creative and bold. And if you are given the subtitle, then it's good, because it would be helpful to clarify who is your audience. For example, here the name of the newsletter is a business volunteer. And if you can see, below that, the word is for the art partner. This is the subtitle of this newsletter that reveals that art partner is the audience of the newsletter. The second part of the newsletter is the body. The body of the newsletter is the bulk of the text, excluding the headline and decorative text elements. It's the article that make up the newsletter content. If you can see here, see this is the headline, 28th day trainings for agriculture input activities, and this is the body of the content. It's excluding headline and photos. The third part of the newsletter is the table of contents. Table of contents usually appearing on the front page. The table of contents briefly list articles and special sections of the newsletter and the page number for those items. If you are seeing here, see this is the column of the newsletter is the table of the content. Here is the list of the articles and the subsection is also given, and in front of that page number is given. The article is like major events, research highlights, fodder for promotion, and the subsection is also given. So it gives you a brief idea that what are the contents incorporated in the newsletter and whether you go through the newsletter or not. Well, the fourth basic component of the newsletter is the masthead. Well, the nameplate and the masthead in print media is somehow used as interchangeably. In a newspaper, the masthead may be equivalent to the nameplate on a newsletter. But in the newsletter, the nameplate and the masthead is different. And I am going to explain what is the difference between the nameplate and the masthead in the newsletter. Well, we had discussed that the nameplate is the banner of the newsletter, but masthead is the list of the name of the publisher and other pertinent data. This section of the newsletter design typically found on the second page. It may include staff name, contributor, subscription information, addresses and logo. See, if you can see here, this is the masthead. You see, there is the name of the patron, editorial board, the staff name, the university logo is also here, and SDO newsletter, the name of the newsletter has been also mentioned here. So it is called the masthead in the newsletter. The next and the most prominent part of the newsletter is a headline just after the nameplate. When I am saying that it is the most prominent part, let's explain this with the example. See, this is the headline. If you can see the major events, extension activities, these are the headline. Take a look at this. Which element caught your attention at first glance? Definitely the first glance, the pictures, and after that the headline. Why it is so? Because the color contrast, the font size, the text, the style of writing, and the graphic accent of the headline is different from the body of the content. So that's why it should be catchy. And at a glance, you catch the picture and you catch the headline. And this is very much essential in the newsletter because headline catch the attention of the reader. So while you're writing for the headline, some point to be pondered. And these points are, the headline must be well written and bold. List headlines and their articles in order of importance. Be consistent and use the same font for all headline. Headline should be larger than body copy but not overpowering. Headline is all upper cases are difficult to read, so combination of upper and lower cases works best. Headline should contrast with body text style, alignment, white space and graphic accent so that they will stand out and not blend in with the body. The next elements of the newsletter is the subhead. The subhead appear within the body text, divides the article into the smaller section, similar to side heading and paragraph heading in a report. If you can see, in the student activities, these are the subhead. The subhead of the student activity is the PG student awarded, World AIDS Day, then Freshers Day celebrated. These are the subhead And this subhead is divided the students' activities into the different sections. So it is very easy to read and approach. The next element of the newsletter designing is the running head or folio. It is also known as a header. A running headline is repetitive text, often the title of the publication. It usually appears at the top of each page or every other page in a newsletter design. Sometimes the page number is also incorporated with the running headline. See here, this is the extension activity, the headline. The content of the extension activity is continued till the next page. If you can see the upper part of the page, on the above side, there is a title of the publication is written. This is the extension activity. It is called running head. Running head used as a teaser, which pushed the reader to continue reading the newsletter and discover its interesting content. If you are giving the headline, running head is to be here, the readers has the knowledge that he or she go through the article under which heading. So we are giving the running head in the newsletter. The next part of the newsletter is a kicker. Kicker is a short phrase positions above the headline, usually as a lead in or introduction. Let me illustrate you with this example. As you can see, here is one article. The headline of article is Fix It Store Helps Improve Quarter. Just above the headline, there is a short phrase, and that phrase is Home Receive Personal Touch. This is the example of kicker. Take the next article, which is Friends and the Famous King. If you see just above the headline, you see the one word Eat, which is situated in the column. It is also an example of the kicker. The next element of the newsletter is a deck. The deck elaborate or expand on the headline and topic of the text. It is a one or more line placed between the headline and the body of the article, provide a segue between the two. Let's give one example to here, explain the deck. If you see, there is a newsletter, the page setter, and the headline of an article is mentioned to continue to support running. Just below the headline, there is a one or two line, and that is 55 years after his college glory days, Brookings' good neighbor maintained his enthusiasm for sports. This is deck. The next element is a page number. As all of you know, the page number can appear at the top of the page or bottom or the side of the pages. Usually page 1 is not numbered in a newsletter. If you can see here, this is the page 1, but it's not numbered here in the newsletter, and it's start with the page 2. So usually the page number 1 is not appeared in the newsletter. Next element of the newsletter is the byline. Byline is the name of author or contributor of a photo or article. It can appear at the beginning or end of the article. The same article I am taking here to illustrate you, like Fried and the King. So in this article, the above is the kicker, which is eat, and below the headline is the deck, the famous King's Inn, and below the deck there is a author name mentioned, that is a script by Helen Brand. This is called byline. You can give the author name at the top of your article or the bottom of the article. The next is the end mark. I think you all know this end mark. It's called a din bat or symbol used to mark the end of an article or story. The next element is pull quotes. Pull quotes is a small quote taken from an article and enlarged to catch the reader's attention. Well, I am saying that it's a pull quote. Pull quote means just excerpts of your findings, excerpt of the article has been pulled and used as a graphic element to catch the attention of the reader and highlight the key points. Take a look at this slide. Through this example, I just describe you what is a pull quote. Here is the article, and the headline of an article is a placement highest in years. This article is related to the placement. See, in column, pull quote is here. Allen has become known nationwide as producing the best educated students in the Southeast. It is the pull quote of this article because this article is related to the placement highest. So some excerpt finding is that Allen may be some center that is producing a best educated students in the southern side. Next is the mugshot. Mugshot is the photograph of a person's head and shoulder with that person looking straight into the camera is called a mugshot. Here, the photograph of a vice chancellor of the SDA University is a good example of the mugshot. And the last elements of the newsletter is the caption. The caption is a phrase, sentence or paragraph describing the content of an illustration such as photography or chart. The caption is usually placed directly above, below or to the side of the picture it describes. If you see here, see in the research highlights, this is the headline. There are the three images. You will find the three pictures that is related to the root note nemoted. And the caption of the each image is given below. For the first image, the caption is root note nemoted infected plant. For the second image, the caption is the root knot nemoted infected root, and the third one is the root knot nemoted infected stand root is captioned. Well, that's about it for now. This brings to me the end of my presentation, and I hope these example gives you a clear idea about what are the basic elements of the newsletter and how you can incorporate in your newsletter. Well, in this session we had talked about the types of the print media and newsletter design. I hope this presentation will definitely grow your practical skills for designing the newsletter. Thanks for watching my video. I look forward to helping you with more cutting-edge content with this regard. Till then, start writing, keep writing, celebrate writing. No matter what it is, forget all the rules and write for yourself. Have a nice day. We'll be right back.